The Yellowstone is a supervolcano in Yellowstone National Park in western United States. It is thousands of times more powerful than a normal-sized volcano. The last supereruption of the Yellowstone supervolcano happened approximately 640,000 years ago. The lava creek eruption ejected approximately 240 cubic miles of rock, dust, and volcanic ash into the atmosphere, and it will erupt again in the near future. What if it erupted tomorrow? Would it be like an atomic bomb? How far would it affect the world? What would happen to the climate? And how would it cool down the Earth's surface? This is Deep Right Zone, and here's what would happen if the Yellowstone volcano erupted tomorrow. If the Yellowstone supervolcano ever had another massive eruption, it could spew ash for thousands of miles across the United States, burning Yellowstone in lava within a 40 miles radius of eruption, the impacts of which would be widespread, from avalanches of hot rock and gases racing down the volcano's flanks to global change in climate. According to recent simulations, those closest to Yellowstone, including southern Alberta to southern Manitoba, would experience ash fall that would cover the landscape up to 1 meter deep, and it could be expected to kill as many as 90,000 people immediately. This would shut down transportation, collapse buildings, short out the electric grid, and cause massive agriculture failure. Ashfall would likely wipe out the Midwest crop of soybean and corn. Much of the America's farmland might also be poisoned for a generation. Airborne ash would drown most air traffic and cause respiratory problems. Debris in the atmosphere could reduce the Earth's surface temperature by several degrees Celsius or more. How? You are confused? Hey, don't be. The small ash particles decrease the amount of sunlight reaching the surface of the Earth and lower average global temperatures. Sulfuric gases released from the volcano would spring into the atmosphere and mix with the planet's water vapor. That can lead to acid rain as well as global cooling, as it reflects the sun away from the Earth. This global cooling event could last for many years, or possibly decades after the eruption. When Pinatubo erupted in 1991, it cooled the planet by about 1 degree C for a few years. The devastation would not be restricted to the local environment. Yellowstone's plume of ash, lava, and volcanic gases would reach a height of 15 miles or more. And from this lofty position, it would be blown across the North America. Ash would darken the skies and blanket the ground from coast to coast, with up to 3 feet of ash falling in the northern Rockies and a few inches over much of the Midwest. Citizens might be mildly amused at first at the black snow, but they would soon realize the danger it presents. But don't worry right now, there is no sign of a pending eruption. Yellowstone Park does continue to get earthquakes. Yellowstone is behaving as it has for the past 140 years. So what do you think about this? Tell us in the comment section below the video. Thanks for watching, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and also press the bell icon to get the notifications of our new episodes.